Bills have one left. Steve Christy, a guy who certainly has upgraded the Bills' place kicking. This day did not start in that matter, missed his first three, but hits one right here from 35. Christy, a guy who spent 2 years with Tampa Bay, signed on Plan B with Buffalo. He has the long range, too. Hit that 59-yarder back in game three. Had two long shots today, not able to connect. But a moment ago, the 35-yard field goal for a 10-7 lead for Buffalo. And it is Sekhahema who is back deep once again, along with Herschel Walker.
And if I'm going to kick the ball to somebody, I'll kick it to that guy, 22, by Sekhahema. He wants to give it back to you for some reason or other.
Well, you know, at age 31, he is the second oldest full-time return man in the league, next to Mel Gray of Detroit, who is the dean at age 32. And it is Sekhahema. You can hear the reaction from the crowd. Sekhahema with a burst, able to hold on, and the flag has been thrown.
They're going to have one of those illegal blocks again in the back.
Number 54 of the receiving team.
Brett Hager, legal block. I mean, everything is going wrong. The wheels fell off a long time. Well, the wheels fell off a long time ago in this ball game. But this is against this defense, and now they're going to just lay back and come on up. They know that, you know, no timeouts except for the 2-minute warning, and that'll be probably after this play.
The Eagles starting from their 14-yard line. In trouble, able to get it off to Walker. Now, was that ball knocked out of his hands, or did he flip it to Walker?
It looked like he flipped it over his shoulder to him. I guarantee you they're not going to put this play in. but Brister is being tackled. Herschel Walker is out here helping out on Bruce Smith. Now, what, Cornelius Bennett is here. Look at the little flip out to the outside. There's Herschel's got it. That's a forward pass. Takes it to 2 minutes.
One-push cleaning bar gives men a closer shave than the three leading disposables. And men say it delivers a safer shave than the three leading disposables. So, for a better overall shave than the three leading disposables, it's the ST from Schick. We're changing the face of shaving.
The affordable portable Motorola pager. The perfect way to stay in touch while you're out holiday shopping.
Oops, gotta go.
It also makes a great stocking stuffer.
Coming up next on most of these NBC stations, game two of our NFL doubleheader. Most of you will see the Kansas City Chiefs take on the Denver Broncos. Now, the last time that Kansas City and Denver met in Mile High back in October of 92, last season, week five, John Elway threw two touchdown passes the final 2 minutes, including that 12-yard completion of Vance Johnson with 38 seconds to go, and the Broncos won 20-19. Kansas City at Denver to be seen by most of the country. Some of you will see the Seahawks battle the Raiders. Off the movement, a series of penalty flags are thrown. Chiefs can clinch the AFC West title for the first time since 71. They need a win over Denver, coupled by a Raiders loss to Seattle. We're down to 2 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter here.
Defense.
The offside against Buffalo.
Still second down.
They just said they're going to pin their ears back and go because they know they got to throw, but can't go a little bit too soon.
It's a second and three at the 21. The Bills have come from behind. They lead the Eagles 10-7. And Brister completes for the first down to Victor Bailey. And now Philadelphia in its version of the hurry up. Philadelphia has used all its timeouts. Down to 1:40 remaining in the fourth. Oh, hard hit on Herschel Walker.
Well, Herschel Walker, he does two things. First of all, he comes up and he helps out on the block with McHale on Bruce Smith. Then he releases, and once he releases, then Cornelius Bennett just drills him. On the outside, Herschel Walker coming up. Here's the ball. Here's Bennett. There goes Herschel. Well, Corey Beck, he has a swizzle stick. He didn't use it for a long time because he chipped a tooth, and that's why he wasn't using it.
Second and 10 at the 33. Bristol threw on the run. Nice catch by Bailey. Well, the Eagles very much alive, trying at least to get into position for a game-tying field goal. That's good for 15 yards.
All right, Bruce Smith breaks through, but he has three people on him, and Bobby Brister just sees the play, looks downfield. Victor Bailey coming back, and that's what you have to do. When you see your quarterback in trouble, come back, give him a target. They did. They get the first down and out of bounds to stop the clock.
Six catches, 81 yards for Bailey. First down from the 48. And that is incomplete, intended for Lofton. Lofton covered by Washington.
That time it looked like Brister was trying to throw the ball away, but he never got it far enough out there, and he just kind of flicked the ball. And I mean, he's been under an awful lot of pressure. He's going to throw and duck. That's the old throw and get out of the way. Phil Hansen, number 90, in his face. Brister is looking to the side. They sent it to play, and he kind of shrugged it off like, are you out of your mind?
Brister doing a lot of throwing. 43 passes thrown this week, 45 last week. That's number 44. Good for a first down with Calvin Williams.
They got to get up on the ball, and these guys are kind of walking. This is, everybody's got to get back and get set. Brister just, see, here's what you should, when you have an incomplete pass, you should try to call at least two plays.
It's a first down at the Buffalo 39, and Brister again completes inside the 30 to Bailey. Clock is running. Eagles do not have any timeouts remaining. They're down to 50 seconds. 13-yard pickup.
Well, they thought, Darrell Talley thought he got a fumble, that Bailey, when he hit the ground, he fumbled the ball. Obviously, the official said no, that he was down.
And now the clock is stopped.
You know, here's the situation, and which I like what Brister did on this drive. He threw two completed passes in the middle of the field because he had a minute and some seconds. When you're playing defense, you get into prevent or zone defenses at the end of the game, Marv, you kind of give the middle because you want him to throw in the middle. So what Brister did, said, okay, if you're going to give it to me, I'm going to take it. Now, they still have 36 seconds left to go. They got it second down. They still have a chance to throw one more in the middle, get up, throw the ball down, and get the field goal to tie the game, put it into overtime. Or go down the middle for the touchdown. But the middle will be open.
It's a second and 10 at the 27. And the flags are thrown with the movement being indicated against the Eagles.
Prior to the snap, still second down.
See, the thing is, Lester...
Due to contractual agreements with the National Football League, we must now leave our coverage of this game so that we may bring you in its entirety the Kansas City Chiefs at Denver Broncos game. However, we will continue to keep you informed of the results of this game. We'll be right back with the Chiefs and the Broncos following these messages from News Channel 4.
Sports Fever almost gives you the shirt off their rack. Buy one shirt, get a second of equal or lesser value at half price. Limit 4. Only at Sports Fever, Mission Center and Blue Ridge Mall.
You drive a car like this and you're going to be asked a lot of questions. Like, what kind of car is that? You say, it's Eagle Vision TSI. They say, oh yeah, a Jeep Eagle. To which you respond, it's not a Jeep Eagle. That's where you buy it. Then you tell them all about its performance technology. Eagles do invite a lot of questions, but the next time someone calls an Eagle Vision a Jeep Eagle, you can tell them where to go.
See your local Jeep and Eagle dealer.
This is the latest from News Channel 4. The body of 10-year-old Cassidy Center is now being laid to rest this afternoon. Cassidy and 9-year-old Angela Houseman are the two young girls kidnapped and murdered in St. Louis within the past few weeks. Police think a serial killer may be at work. Soldiers at Fort Riley are playing Santa's helpers. They're repairing bicycles and dolls for underprivileged children. More news in 1 hour from Kansas City's 24-hour News Channel.
The News Channel 4 update is brought to you by Superior Lexus.
Ladies and gentlemen, you got a tape!
Colorado, celebrating 24 years of sellouts, welcomes the best in the AFC West, the Kansas City Chiefs against the Denver Broncos. Hello, everyone. Dick Enberg with Bob Trumpy. The weather forecast has snow coming by halftime. How will that impact what we see early?
The weather can change here in a hurry, Dick. There's no question about that. This is a grass field. It's prescription athletic turf. It shouldn't be too bad. But there is now a premium of the first half performance for both teams, not just the home team. And for Marty Schottenheimer, as many times as he's played up here, he certainly knows that you got to have a quick start here in Denver just in case the snow does come in.
Wade Phillips, his counterpart. The Broncos have dominated Kansas City here at Mile High, winning 10 in a row. And it's Kansas City's Harvey Williams taking the kneel down. Touchback at the 20-yard line. Williams seeing his first duty since he was KO'd in Miami more than a month ago. And here comes Super Joe Montana with a flag down in the end zone of the Chiefs.
Well, that was
John Wall,
late.
Dave Zott, Tim Grunard, Will Shields, the rookie, and Ricky Siglar, the offensive line. Montana with the incomparable Marcus Allen, Kimball Anderson.
We have an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty against the Broncos. 15-yard penalty, first down.
So Bernie Kukar, an early voice, 15 for Kansas City. They'll start from the 35-yard line.
Dick, that was just foolishness. I don't know who the penalty was on. I don't know what it was, but the ball was down in the end zone. I mean, you want great plays out of great players, but you want them to play smart. Let's see if we can pick up what happens.
Some taunting, apparently, as Joe Montana comes out throwing. And hitting, a diving catch by J.J. Burton, or is it Willie Davis? It's Davis with a grab at the 41-yard line. Dave Wyman covers for the Broncos. Shane Brunette will not see these in any particular order. Forget about down linemen, linebackers. You can mix those any way you want. Craig and Williams, Kroll, Mecklenburg, perhaps another Pro Bowl for him. Wyman, Simon Fletcher deserves to go to the Pro Bowl, according to Marty Schottenheimer, the KC coach. Braxton, watch Frank Robinson. He replaces Charles Demery. Demery out until the playoffs. Knee injury against San Diego. Marcus Allen's first carry, shy of a first down. He needed three, he got two. It's third and one. Simon Fletcher with a tackle.
Dick, this is so important for Denver to shut down this Kansas City running game. And the Chiefs' victory in Kansas City, the Chiefs rushed for 160 yards, and what that does is puts in the play-action fake. It draws safeties to the line of scrimmage to help support the run. That is a huge key for Denver.
Third, it's closer to 2 yards than one. Montana having another sensational season. 8 touchdowns, only 2 interceptions. Play-action fake. And he gets it to Anders, and the fullback has a first down at the Denver 48. And what a quick trigger by Montana under pressure from Mike Kroll.
And Dick, when he rolls out, watch him throw it sidearm. 51, Kroll is all over him. Watch the sidearm throw. to get it out to Kimball Anders. Beautifully executed. Another one of those things of the San Francisco style of offense. Throw it 2 yards. The guy runs for five more, and it's a first down.
A throw by Montana that brought tears to the eyes of Dave Craig.
Yes.
So Montana has them in Denver territory and gives to Marcus Allen with a big hole at the 40. And Allen, who's found the fountain of youth in the Midwest, is to the 35 on a 12-yard gallop. Steve Atwater makes the stop for the Broncos.
Now, one of the things that's changed about this Kansas City offensive line is the ability to pull Marcus Allen right up behind Siglar, the right tackle. Excellent job of getting up through there. That's Will Shields. I have misidentified him. Not Siglar. Will Shields, 68, the rookie from Nebraska.
Allen with 10 touchdowns rushing to lead the NFL. The long throw for Willie Davis, and it lands 5 yards too long. Coverage by Tyrone Braxton. It was Davis who caught Montana's first touchdown pass when he joined the Chiefs. Yeah, when in Tampa Bay.
Dick, Denver's choice there, a strong safety blitz. Dennis Smith came from about 15 yards deep. Didn't get there in time, and that's why Joe Montana tried for that deep fly route.
Second down, 10. Montana to Burton. Shy of the first down at the 26, tackled by Frank Robinson. As we welcome those of you who have watched the Buffalo Bills rally to a 10-7 victory here in Denver. Dick Enberg with Bob Trumpy. First series of the game as Kansas City has taken the kickoff down to the 25-yard line with a healthy spot of first down at the Broncos 25. 11:45 remaining opening quarter.
And Dick, think about this opening drive. A couple of runs, a sprint by Joe Montana, a couple of square ends, just this multiple Kansas City offense that Joe Montana is so comfortable with.
Kimball Anders and the toss, and chopped down as Dennis Smith, the veteran all-pro safety, races up from his deep position. We welcome those who have watched New England win its second of the year, a 7-2 baseball score over the Cincinnati Bengals. Here in Denver, the Chiefs take the opening kickoff and have marched now to the 26-yard line of the Broncos, second down and 11. 4 minutes into the quarter. Joe Montana leading the Chiefs, trying to do something Kansas City hasn't accomplished in more than a decade, and that's win here in Denver. Marcus Allen, the lone running back. The throw to the tight end, Jonathan Hayes, and he has a first down at the Denver 12. Lilo Lang pushes him out of bounds, 14-plus on the play.
Dick, the Denver Broncos choice there, what they call their Tiger defense. Here's the tight end right here. He just runs a crossing route, but they have seven defensive backs in the ball game. And Joe Montana recognizes it perfectly. He's got the one guy in single coverage, Jonathan Hayes, with Lilo Lang. And how does Joe Montana always seem to make the right choice? Answer me that question.
Hayes, 16th catch of the year, still looking for a touchdown. The drive continues from the opening kickoff. Montana to Jonathan Hayes, and he's got his first score. Atwater with a tackle. Kansas City with an impressive march engineered by Joe Montana.
That was a thing of beauty. Dick, last night we were talking to Joe Montana. We talked to ask him about the offense, and he said, look, we have a hot guy on every single offensive throw. And in this particular instance, you're going to see the strong safety Dennis Smith blitzes. Joe Montana recognizes it. Hayes gets the reception for the score.
Veteran Nick Lowry adds the extra point, a 65-yard drive. 8 plays, 11 on the touchdown to Jonathan Hayes.
He recognizes it beautifully. That's an easy score for Kansas City.
There's no stealing the thunder. No. Can't be
people have something they're willing to pay a premium for. For some, it's art. For some, it's entertainment. For others, it's travel. Acura. Some things are worth the price.
Before you thought to dream, Canon had a vision. Before you have a problem, Canon has the solution. We have a way of looking ahead to give your office unlimited possibilities right now. When the rest say you can't, Canon says you can. Canon, now you can.
Here's the touchdown. Strong safety, Dennis Smith. Weak safety, Steve Atwater. Here is Jonathan Hayes. Watch the pick run by Cash on Mike Kroll right at the line of scrimmage. Joe Montana, again, recognizes Smith up at the line of scrimmage. Possibility of the blitz. Hits the hot receiver. Atwater can't keep him out of the end zone.
Len Milburn and Robert Delpino now back to receive as they work on Jonathan Hayes, perhaps injured as he was tackled by Atwater, working on his left shoulder.
Actually, I think they're just checking his pulse, Dick. You know, he's the diabetic.
Right, takes insulin 2-3 times a day. Milburn won't take the gamble. And Denver's Sean Elway will start at the 20-yard line. Well, they have a lot of adjectives for number 7 here in Denver as well. One of the great players, and perhaps not with the cast that Montana has enjoyed in his years with San Francisco, now in Kansas City. The offensive line you saw, Bernstein from San Diego is the leading rusher. Reggie Johnson back after a couple of weeks from an injury. Arthur Marshall and Derek Russell. Shannon Sharp, the leading receiver. Milburn and Kimbrough come in pass situations. Toss to Bernstein. No gain. Tackled by Tracy Rogers and Neil Smith. Defensively,
Dick, watch what happens on a switch. Watch number 30. Bayless come in there, makes Bernstein cut up underneath. An easy tackle for Neil Smith.
Middle short game to Sharp, 5 yards on the play. 3rd and 5. Now we'll look at the defense of the Kansas City Chiefs with Neil Smith, Joe Phillips, Sally Amua, and Derek Thomas playing on the line. Rogers, Simeon, and Marks, the backers. Albert Lewis, and not afraid to put him man on man, nor Dale Carter, the second year corner from Tennessee. Bayless is a hitter, and so is Ross at safety, and Jay Taylor's their nickelback. Thomas, occasionally wearing that visor, elects to employ it today. 3rd and 4. Elway with a shuttle throw, and Bernstein has a first down, and the flag is down. Was he beyond the line of scrimmage when he made the toss forward? Derek Thomas applied the pressure for Kansas City. Illegal forward pass is the call.
Yeah, I don't think that was designed to be a pass. That was designed to be a quarterback draw all the way.
An illegal forward pass on the quarterback. He was across the line of scrimmage. 5-yard penalty, also loss of down.
Dick, you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 defensive backs. So this is a quarterback draw. It is not intended to be a pass. You can see where the line of scrimmage is just in front of the 25. When Thomas makes contact, Elway, always the creator, tries to make something out of the play. It cost him 5 yards and the down.
And remember, it's where the ball is, not the player. And the ball was forward for Elway. Had it been back in a passing mode, a regular passing mode, that might have been okay. But the ball was forward. Carter is the deep man at the 30 of Kansas City. Boy, this kid ruined it. Look at this punt as he's been kicking the hair out of it. Carter at the 20. Waits for his blockers. And on come the orange jersey. A 6-yard return for Carter on a 60-yard punt. poke in this. Tom Ruin booted.
Paying for quality can be a difficult decision at first. But over time, it gets a lot easier to live with. Acura. Some things are worth the price.
After months of searching, a remarkable method was found that proves big pizza toppings equal big pizza taste.
I think we should just eat it.
Excellent idea.
Big chunks do mean big taste.
Mm-hmm.
New chunky-style pizza from Pizza Hut. Big chunks, big taste, big idea.
Great. Once-in-a-lifetime interview and you oversleep? Move it.
Norelco introduces the Compact Speed Racer. When you have to put your best face forward on the go, the new Norelco Speed Racer. Close and comfortable to go.
I don't get it. Some guy bets 228 and makes 3 million bucks.
Can you imagine what Willie Mays would be worth today?
Yeah.
No holiday sweepstakes.
Another Heineken, right?
Yeah, please.
No blimp with our name on it. No racing team. None of that is what made Heineken the number one imported beer in America.
Where's all that money come from?
Ticket prices. Yeah, I guess. And all those beer commercials.
The NFL on NBC is brought to you by Acura. Some things are worth the price. By Dr. Pepper and your local Dr. Pepper bottler. Dr. Pepper is just what the doctor ordered. By ITT. When it comes to building businesses, at ITT, we're adding more than just our name. And by Heineken, just being the best is enough.
Chiefs with the ball for the second time. Joe Montana just dissecting the Denver defense on the first possession, driving them quickly, 5 for 6 passing to that 7-0 lead. Play action. Down the middle. What a catch by J.J. Burton at the 46-yard line. A 19-yard play. Atwater and Robinson with the tackle.
Yeah, Frank Robinson taking the place of Charles Dimery. Dimery was the Broncos' best coverage cornerback. Montana sets, looks, quickly throws. Robinson, 36. He went to Boise State. He played Montana. He played Montana State. But today he's playing Joe Montana.
There he is, 36, Frank Robinson, who grew up in the San Francisco area, rooting for Joe Montana.
Not today.
The lay to Marcus Allen. It gets a couple to the 48-yard line. Well, with that touchdown pass to Jonathan Hayes, Montana edges closer on the all-time list to another great quarterback. He moves within one of Dan Fouts for the number 5 spot all time. Fran Tarkenton way out there, and of course Dan Marino there in second place at 298. There's eyes of Montana surveying the defense. Second and 8. Ronnie Bradford to the 49. A flag is down. We're going to say he is down. Excuse me, he's down at the 41-yard line. Well, they had a big article with Bradford in the Denver papers this week. They've been kidding him about not making an interception. And he said, well, this will be the week, and how prophetic it was for this young man from Colorado.
I have a feeling he might keep this football. Jones runs the wrong pattern. Joe Montana he's making all kinds of motions towards Jones. He was down there. It goes back. Joe Montana's third interception of the season.
Don't you wish you could be this comfortable with all your decisions? Some things are worth the price.
An insurance company insures many things, but mostly it's there to ensure the quality of people's lives. And last year, backed by a $680 million investment from ITT, ITT Hartford helped 5 million people by paying for over $5 billion in personal and business losses, one person at a time. If you're looking for insurance, look to the insurance company of ITT. ITT, we're adding more than just our name. Do you dream in color? In bottomless blues and screaming yellows? In sounds that shake you to the bottom of your heart? In images clear as crystal and brilliant as ice? In faraway worlds as close as your fingertips? These are what dreams and Sony Trinitron televisions are made of. Make one come true for you. It's your life. Isn't it worth a Sony?
We thought Montana's pass didn't have much on it. Here's why.
Dan Williams, number 90, gets his hand up. And you can see it just takes all the steam off the ball. Bradford makes the interception. He may put that one on his mantle.
Wouldn't you?
Yes, I would.
Ball at the 40. Denver gets the first turnover. And you know how Marty Schottenheimer feels about those turnovers. Give it to Robert Del Pino. Galloping into the open. A 17-yard rumble to the 43-yard line. Kevin Ross made the stop.
Interesting choice here by Denver. Motion carries one linebacker away from the line of scrimmage. They run inside Derek Thomas. There you see Rogers, 52, follows Bernstein, 33, out to the sideline. And there's a nice big gap for Robert Del Pino to pick up. Nice yardage and a first down.
The first for the Broncos, 6:19 left, opening quarter. They wrestle in the slot, give it to Bernstein. Oh, running off that left side, another big chunk. Ross, another stop. Derek Russell, a good blocking wide receiver, number 85, through a key block.
Just straight ahead blocking here by the Denver Broncos offensive line. Excellent block by Shannon Sharp, too. This is very important for Denver. Last time these two teams met, the Broncos rushed for just 35 yards.
And there is Russell, who have led the way for Bernstein, with Vance Johnson out for the year with a broken leg. Russell and Marshall becoming the new wide receivers, playing the roles of Mark Jackson and Vance Johnson, who for so many years were on the receiving end of Elway's dramatic efforts.
And this is the thinnest part of the Denver Broncos team. There are just not a lot of people. Let's see if we can see what happens to Russell. He's blocking on Dale Carter. Oh, he's blocking. Oh, goodness. They rolled right up the back of his leg. Right-hand side. Here he is right here. Watch what happens when Tracy Rogers rolls right on his left leg. The ankle turns underneath. And several other different degrees of the compass. And I don't think we can expect Russell back from that bit of video.
Gain of almost 10 on the play. It'll be second and inches. Going back to week three, the Chiefs really ran the ball for only 35 yards of Denver against the Chiefs.
2.5 yards of carry.
So those last two runs by Bernstein and Del Pino have to be encouraging for Wade Phillips. And Bernstein in motion. Give to Del Pino, who has the first down to the 31-yard line. Robert Del Pino with his own cheering group. Mother Reba credits her with everything. Raised 8 children by herself. His fiance Danielle is a cheerleader for the San Francisco 49ers. He met her when she was a cheerleader with the Rams.
Here in Denver supporting Robert. And then when the 49ers play at home, then she flies to San Francisco and cheers for the 49ers. But we know where her heart lies with the Denver Broncos.
5:15 or better to the first quarter. A triple right formation with Marshall in motion. Wide open. Owen picks up Marshall. And he's to the 18-yard line. First down.
13 yards on the play.
He's the man in motion. You can see him coming in motion. He goes back out this way, and the Kansas City defense just forgets him. He's not the primary receiver. You can see John Elway looking downfield. But that is what you call flooding an area, and there's no coverage until Dale Carter is over there to stop him.
Cedric Tillman has replaced Russell. He's wide right. Marshall in the slot. Bernstein. Great effort by Dale Carter. He spoiled the play. It appeared to have something in it, but Carter coming up from a corner just dumped a couple of blockers and ruined the effort.
It's hard to get outside on these defenses nowadays, Dick. You see the outside linebacker come outside, and there's 34. Great call. Went right at his legs, allowed everyone else to catch up with him, and Martz makes the tackle. Well, you like that corner support like that.
Carter does so many things. In fact, such a great athlete, they've used him like Deion Sanders as a wide receiver this year. Second and long. Sharp couldn't get down that low. Lonnie Martz on the coverage. Third and long for Elway, trailing 7-0.
Very poorly thrown by John Elway. As gifted as these young men are, John Elway with his arm, probably the hardest thing he has to do is throw it gently, just 2 or 3 yards over the line of scrimmage.
Well, Sterling Sharp, Shannon's older brother, the great receiver with the Green Bay Packers, undoubtedly watching this before they play down in San Diego tonight. Shannon calls him his father. He calls him every week. More like a father than a brother. Offside was Neil Smith. Was he pulled off?
Well, Neil Smith.
So Freeman made it.
Neil Smith just put his hand right in Bernie Kukar's face accidentally.
Ball start, number 65 on the offense prior to snap, 5-yard penalty, still third down.
Gary Zimmerman and then Smith. Oh my!
Kukar may need a bandage across his nose like Smith has there before the game is over.
Right.
It was accidental, no penalty. You know, Bernie's tough.
He's marking down the number though. It's like a soccer official. He's been carded. Fake the draw, and then they throw to Sharp. Sharp tackle by Albert Lewis, who knew that they needed big yardage, gave him a couple of steps, made sure of the stop, and on comes the field goal unit. And Derek Russell, with that injured ankle, as soon as we have a full report, we'll share it with you.
The Broncos lost Vance Johnson a couple of weeks ago to a badly injured ankle.
Jason Elam, the number 3 pick from the University of Hawaii, been in a bit of a slump. This is just outside the 35, the 35 or 36 yards. Nothing wrong with that one. 36 yards, smoothly done by Elam, and Denver's on the board. 7-3 late in the opening quarter.
Cold filter, Miller Genuine Draft. For those who've discovered a smooth draft taste, the world is a very cool place. But now I'm a man, way
past 21. The problem with cotton pants is they come out of the dryer with all these wrinkles. But hey, Haggar wrinkle-free cottons are 100% cotton. They come out of the dryer wrinkle-free. And really, really hot.
Oh. Haggar wrinkle-free cotton, 100% cotton, 0% wrinkles.
You can see Wayne's World 2 at theater soon and head for McDonald's Holiday Film Festival for the original video, Wayne's World.
Cool.
It's just $5.99 when you buy any large sandwich. But hurry, what you want is what you get at McDonald's today.
Most people have something they're willing to pay a premium for. For some, it's art. For some, it's entertainment. For others, Acura. Some things are worth the price.
Wow, is it cold here in Denver. At least put your jacket
not
on.
Yet,
make
not
me
yet.
Look good.
I will.
Pro Bowl ballots are out around the NFL, and the fans get a chance to vote. And, of course, Simon Fletcher, many feel he's been overlooked, including Marty Schottenheimer. And there's something missing also when you look at the ballot in the AFC running backs.
Yeah, run down that spot, and the first name that should be on there is Marcus Allen. So if he's going to make the Pro Bowl, he's going to have to do it as a write-in candidate. Leads the conference in touchdowns. He's at least deserving of the Pro Bowl.
Well, the coaches and players vote as well, and fans now, one-third, one-third, one-third. Harvey Williams will not be taunted this time, and it'll be Montana starting at the 20-yard line. Well, the Bears on quite a run. Their defense continues to play great, but lost to Tampa Bay today, 13-10. As we look ahead to next weekend here on NBC, the standings in the NFC Central still wide open. The Bears now at 7-6. Detroit playing a late game Green Bay tonight, and Elway and the Broncos will go against the Bears. Maybe not Harbaugh. He was injured. Peter Tom Willis finished it up today in Tampa. That's next Saturday, NBC NFL action. Montana off play action. They don't want him to do that. He ducks out of bounds after a pickup of almost 6 yards. And it was on a similar play, you fans will recall, against the Raiders, where he was hit by Aaron Wallace as he went out of bounds and came up with a hamstring injury.
In Arrowhead Stadium. But a guy like Joe Montana, doctors, coaches, wives, fathers, mothers can tell him during the week, don't run. When Sunday comes and you put those spikes on, all bets are off. I'm going to do anything and everything I can to gain positive yardage and win the game.
37 years old, his 15th season. Marcus Allen, no pup himself, but gets only a yard there as Carl Mecklenburg. Is that a collision? Two greats. Allen with a ball and Mecklenburg, the 11-year linebacker from Minnesota, the tackler.
Will play next year. Here he is right here. His responsibility in his defense has increased. Started out his career in the NFL as a nose tackle. That's why he wears 77. He's moved up the evolutionary ladder. Now gets to stand on 2 feet a lot of times. But was too small to play in high school, too small to play in college, and has been an all-pro linebacker for several years for the Broncos.
Yeah, he went to Augustana College before Minnesota. No one really recruited him from big schools. Third down, and I don't think Montana got it off in time. It's complete to Jones, out of bounds at the 41. But the flag goes down from the back judge. That's usually delay of game.
A delay of game on the offense prior to the snap. 5-yard penalty, still third down.
Nick, I'm telling you, this 40-second clock that the NFL uses, I'm going to be blunt, sucks. I don't like any part of it. You need motion and you need substitutions. And Marty Schottenheimer is on the competition committee, and put that in big letters.
Well, you go from, no, don't, you don't have to say it. You went from evolutionary theory to that, all within two plays.
People are worried about points scored in the NFL. Get rid of that 40-second clock.
Well, I think Joe Gibbs agrees with that. He made those comments yesterday that it's really made it tough on offenses to change plays, get the play in. Todd McNair in motion. Montana with a flag down. Hits the tight end Keith Cash out at the 37-yard line. And we've got holding Kansas City.
I think Simon Fletcher coming around the corner was putting the pressure on.
It was Kansas City in the earlier game that saw Denver being penalized 14 times in their victory 15-7.
That's 12 penalties in the first half in Kansas City.
Holding, number 66 on the offense, 10-yard penalty.
Ricky Sigler, former 49er, didn't play the last 2 years and now is a starter here in Kansas City.
Fletcher is a phenomenon around the corner. Not big, 240 pounds. That's a 280-pound offensive tackle he's running around.
So Sigler costs Kansas City 10. Third and 17 for Montana, who goes long, and too long for Jones.
well covered, and the Kansas City will hack the kick from deep in their own end, and the fans love the defense.
The Kansas City Chiefs are facing double rotation zone, and Wade Phillips knows anytime you can stop Kansas City and Joe Montana, that's a big plus for his football team.
Barker's numbers, 42 and a half, his long this year, 56. No pressure. Sands a beauty. Milburn, the rookie from Stanford. Has a lot of chance. 50. And Lonnie Marks gets him at the 47-yard line. A 46-yard kick, 12-yard return, flag down. See if they're going to bring this one back on the illegal use of the hands.
They usually do, don't they? Yep.
So instead of the 47 in Kansas City territory, as you look at Marty's brother Kurt Schottenheimer in charge of the special teams of the Chiefs. The Broncos will back up.
Illegal block in the back. Number 58 on the return team, on the run back. 10-yard penalty. First down.
Elijah Alexander.
The block is going to take place right here, Dick. I don't think there's any question. You have to have your head clearly in front of the other person. And what these kids have to learn is when that ball is in the air, the officials are looking for only one thing. And that is an illegal block in the back.
Away from the 39-yard line. Playing without one of his starting wide receivers, Derek Russell. Bernstein for the hold. The big guy from Texas A&M has almost nine on the play. Well, we come down to the final seconds of this opening quarter. John Elway handicapped. He's lost his top two receivers this last month. First Vance Johnson and now Derek Russell. It's a 7-3 game. End of one at Mile High Denver.
There is a sound you can hear above the music, the sound of German being spoken by those whose passion is to live life. In your town, America, and the world, Beck's, the number one imported German beer.
Look, a rainbow!
There!
Over there!
Where?
Oh, there! Don't you see
where?
It? I can, through my Panasonic Palm Quarter color viewfinder.
Where?
I hardly noticed it through my black and white viewfinder, but I'm sure I got it on tape.
Great, let's go see. Do your camcorder tapes play a VHS recorder?
No.
Oh, well, my palmcorder tapes will.
Oh.
Why didn't you just get a palmcorder?
I don't know.
The choice is obvious. The Panasonic palmcorder, its tapes will play in your VCR.
The water on the left is being heated by electricity. On the right, by gas. For the cost of heating this much water with electricity, we'd like to show you how much more you can get with gas. And if your neighborhood doesn't have natural gas, you can still heat for less than electricity with propane gas. So no matter where you live, why settle for the water on the left when gas gives you all that hot water on the right? Gas, America's best energy value.
Welcome back. We're ready for the second quarter. 7-3 Kansas City. The Chiefs trying to become the first AFC team to win 10 games. The Giants won their 10th earlier today, beating Indianapolis at the Meadowlands. We open the second quarter, 7-3, Broncos down, and they have a second and short at their own 46-yard line. Bernstein, first down to the Kansas City 49-yard line. Takes half the Chiefs defense to bring him to the ground. Welcome from those of you who've seen the Houston Oilers win their seventh in a row as they defeat the Cleveland Browns with four Del Greco field goals. Make that eight in a row for the Oilers after that horrendous start. Jack Pardee's team we have to talk about them in the playoff superlatives. Have lost one of their top receivers, Derek Russell, with an injury, and Elway stays on the ground. Bernstein for a couple. Joe Montana took the opening kickoff, drove his team downfield, and for those of you who have joined us late, found his tight end Jonathan Hayes wide open as Hayes scores his first of the season.
Yeah, they caught the Denver Broncos in a safety blitz, and Montana has, as he always seems to do, read it perfectly, and Hayes makes it an easy reception for a touchdown.
Second down, eight for Denver at the 46 of Kansas City. The Broncos 3 points on a 36-yard field goal by Jason Elam. Bernstein all three carries on this drive, and he gets it again. Charles Mincy, 42, comes up to help out Neil Smith.
Well, the Kansas City Chiefs are doing a great job of support. They had six defensive backs on the out on the field there, and were able to stop that run. I mean, normally with six defensive backs, you don't expect a lot of run support, but Dave Adolph's defense, a lot of changing up going on both sides of the ball here, Dick.
Third and six. Quarterback's right up on the line of scrimmage for Kansas City. Elway goes long. And well covered was Arthur Marshall. Kevin Ross would not let him get outside.
And you know, the other thing that Kevin Ross did well, there was a blitz up front. Again, Kansas City coming with a lot of extra defensive backs.
But remember, Ross told us he's now listed as a safety, but their play, he says, I'm still a lot of cornerback too.
Sure, but the smart thing here is, watch what happens. He makes sure the receiver stays inside him. Inside him, there's no place for John Elway to throw the ball to make the completion. That's the corner part of Kevin Ross at safety.
Tom Rowan aims for the corner and doesn't make it. Touchback will take it out to the 20-yard line. 43, but 23 on the net, and we have a timeout.
Dr. Pepper, the taste you've been looking for.
You're looking at the most powerful import pickup ever built. The new 4-liter V6 Mazda truck. What all the beautiful people are driving this year.
It's Domino's $25 million Super Mario All-Star Instant Win Game. With every order, get a free chance to win thousands of special power set prizes. Now buy our new crunchy thin crust pizza and get free twisty bread.
Something for nothing when you call Domino's.
Just try Black & Decker's Power Driver with Torque Control. You'll notice one major difference, the clutch. The higher the setting, the more powerful it gets. Power Driver and Power Driver with Torque Control from Black & Decker.
Behind every new Mazda truck is an unsurpassed 50,000-mile, 3-year basic warranty. And behind that, who knows?
The NFL on NBC is brought to you by Domino's Pizza. Call Domino's Pizza now, and you'll be enjoying our new crunchy thin crust pizza during halftime.
Back with the 76,000-plus. Selling out another Bronco home game here at Mile High Stadium. 187 consecutive sellout. Kick in the end zone by Tom Rowan. So Montana leading 7-3, opens at the 20-yard line. Incomplete, intended for Willie Davis, covered by Tyrone Braxton. Let's go to New York in this NFL update.
And while you're at Mile High in the Coliseum, the Raiders fight for their playoff lives. A Raider loss and a Kansas City victory clinches the AFC West for the Chiefs. So what happens? Raiders lead 3-love in the second quarter. Chris Warren goes in for Seattle, and the Seahawks are on top 7-3. Back to Dick and Bob.
All right, Jim, Seattle's always played well down there in Los Angeles. Dave Craig had some big games against the Raiders. Second and 10. Give to Marcus Allen. Boy, is that a typical San Francisco offense call? Second and 10, run the ball, and Allen gets six and has 24 in the game.
Front guard pulls. You see Shields out in front. Actually, this is well defense by Denver, but they're still able to pick up 4, 5, or 6 yards. And yes, that's a purpose play. It makes you respect the run. We prefer to throw it.
Montana now in a pass situation, third and 4. Is 6 for 10. If you look at Allen's numbers, 3 consecutive incomplete. Not this one, Todd McNair. And McNair has a first down at the 38. Tackled by Robinson and Dennis Smith.
Now, Dick, this offense that Paul Hackett and Joe Montana brought to Kansas City is so versatile. The people in Kansas City got to be just overjoyed looking at this, because before they were there, it was just give it to Okoye, give it to Word. And here's an extra running back running a little sneak underneath everybody else, clearing out for an easy pickup and another first down.
Well, McNair's had really good numbers this year. He's averaging 8.6 a yard rushing, and he's always been one of their top receivers. Marcus tripped up. Shane Dronette able to get a piece of his body on him, and Allen goes down at the line of scrimmage.
It did look like they caught feet. That's an easy tackle for Shane Dronette. Now again, the Kansas City Chiefs choice here is to run outside. Dronette comes from the backside. Yeah, he just runs right in the block. Yeah, he steps on his foot. That's the easiest tackle he'll make this year.
Keep your uniform well clean that way. Allen in the flat. After a yard gain, good play by Tyrone Braxton.
That was a great tackle.
Radar Braxton from North Dakota State.
He's the last guy left out there. Normally you'd like to have this thrown a little stronger, but Joe has to put it over the outstretched arms of 73 Fletcher, and it just allows Braxton to make a beautiful tackle for little or no gain.
So it's third and 10. 7 defensive backs for the Broncos. No one behind Montana, and that's Dennis Smith coming right up into his face. Timeout, Montana.
Now see, this is the beautiful part of the game of football, adjusting to what the defense does. But the clock won't allow you to do that anymore.
But, you know, there are always commercials to bide your time.
Oh.
It seems the more time goes by, the fancier trucks get.
Just a bunch of chrome and snazzy stripes.
What the?
Fusion?
No.
So Mazda went and asked folks what a truck should be.
I need a real truck.
And learned one very important lesson.
You don't run through mud and ballet slippers.
Introducing the bigger.
It's bigger.
Meaner.
It's meaner.
All-new Mazda truck. The only import with a 4-liter V6 and one monster warranty.
Got to tow my dinosaur.
The new Mazda truck.
I like my dinosaur. It's a good dinosaur.
Mazda. It just feels right.
Gulf of Mexico, where world-class fishermen like Jim come to battle the big boys.
Jim, you got one.
Yeah, hey, this calls for a celebration. How about a cold O'Doul?
Thanks.
Ah, only 70 calories and not alcohol, because out here, you never know what's biting.
When you want the refreshing taste of beer without all the alcohol, think O'Doul's. It's what beer drinkers drink when they're not drinking beer.
Today, 19,000 people will start their day at sunrise. Thousands of fathers will hold their child for the first time. And millions of people will keep track of their time with a Citizen Watch in Paris. It's a Citizen Elegance. In the South Pacific, a Citizen Promaster. But from Nepal to New York, more people depend on a watch made by Citizen than any other timepiece. Citizen Watches, how the world until it's time.
The NFL on NBC is brought to you by O'Doul's. It's what beer drinkers drink when they're not drinking beer. By Mazda. Mazda, it just feels right. By the Citizen Watch Company, because Citizen is how the world tells time. And by Schick Tracer, it traces every curve on your face.
Dip on the last play, watch what happens. Montana realizes the 25-second clock has expired, calls a timeout. The defense celebrates. If they use up a timeout.
Now on third and 10. Montana complete to Willie Davis, and Davis hit in the secondary by Darryl Hall, 15 yards for Montana, first down Kansas City.
He's so cool in the pocket, and the last time these two teams met, Davis had six catches for 139 yards. Look at him looking around, reading, has great confidence in Willie Davis, a young man who ran the wishbone in college at Central Arkansas, really had to teach himself to catch the ball, and now his dream fulfilled, catching it from Joe Montana.
Yeah, he learned his craft in the World League at Orlando, and now running the Jerry Rice version of the offense. Play action to Marcus, and the throw complete. J.J. Burton. Dennis Smith wrestles him down at the 27-yard line. 20 more.
Part of this offense and the problem that Kansas City has had is the two people that know it best are Paul Hackett and Joe Montana. Now, Burton almost makes a mistake here. He doesn't carry in far enough. That's almost tipped away by Braxton, 34. You see Burton when he runs his square in, and see if he keeps carrying in. That's the pattern that Joe's looking for, but accuracy makes the completion.
If Willie Davis is the Jerry Rice, J.J. Burton is the John Taylor of the offense, and now it's Marcus Allen, and he's hit by Mike Kroll. Kroll seemed to be free in the backfield.
Well, this Denver defense is not big, and you don't know when somebody's going to blitz. Here's Kroll on the inside of Jonathan Hayes, 85. Jonathan Hayes misses the block right there to stop Marcus Allen for a loss.
It'll be second and 11.
This Denver defense, you got to take a second at the line of scrimmage just to identify who's there if you're Kansas City.
Tim Barnett to the right, and Fred Jones split left. Montana down the middle, complete to Barnett, who's inside the five. Atwater and Smith make the stop. 24 more for Joe.
Man, this is... you run out of adjectives. Again, looking straight down the middle, and then he goes to the right at the last second. He picked again the one receiver that's got single coverage. They had Cash down the middle. This is Braxton. You're going to see on the left, Cash is double covered right at the end of this play. There's the double coverage on the tight end. Montana again makes the right choice.
Leading 7-3, first and goal at the four, and Montana super again. The interception came on a tip pass, and Ronnie Bradford picked it off for the Denver Broncos late in the first quarter. Second timeout spent by Kansas City, middle of the second quarter.
People around Flat Rock, Michigan have a lot of reasons to be proud, one of which is building the Mazda 626. Because even with dual airbags and a V6 engine, it still costs less than a four-cylinder Camry LE. Six cylinders that cost less than four? People in Flat Rock think that's a powerful argument for the 626. And so do we. Mazda. It just feels right.
And now for some thin, different.
New Domino's Thin Crust Pizza. A crispy, crunchy crust pizza. Now, buy any thin crust pizza and get an order of Domino's Twisty Bread free.
Something for nothing when you call Domino's.
The problem with cotton pants is they come out of the dryer with all these wrinkles. But hey, Haggar wrinkle-free cottons are 100% cotton. They come out of the dryer wrinkle-free. And really, really hot.
Oh. Haggar wrinkle-free cotton. 100% cotton, 0% wrinkles.
Since your face can't adjust to your razor should adjust to your face, which is exactly why we designed the Schick Tracer. The Schick Tracer is the only razor with blades that bend and flex to the unique shape of your face. So the Tracer gets in close for a clean, comfortable shave. And since you can't change your face, maybe you should change your razor. Schick, we're changing the face of shaving.
New Year's Day is Championship Saturday on NBC as 10th-ranked Miami takes on Arizona in the IBM OS2 Fiesta Bowl. Then number 4 Notre Dame battles number 7 Texas A&M in the Mobile Cotton Bowl, followed by a primetime showdown for the national championship as number 1 Nebraska faces Heisman winner Charlie Ward and number 2 Florida State in the Federal Express Orange Bowl. New Year's Day.
Dick, again, Joe Montana makes the right choice. You're going to see double coverage here. You're going to see double coverage here. Here's the single coverage, and he's the guy that Joe Montana picks and makes the completion. How does he know?
He just sees the field so magnificently. First and goal at the 4, 7-3, Kansas City. Marcus Allen, he's in the end zone again. The man who leads the NFL in rushing touchdowns has his 11th of the year on the ground and his 14th of the season.
Understand that Kansas City has won 21 of the last 25 games they have played against AFC West opponents. They are 5-0 in the division this year, and Joe Montana and Marcus Allen are two big reasons why. Huge reasons.
Kansas City has scored 11 touchdowns on the ground. That man has all 11. Lowry for the extra point. Ooh, snap. A good job done by Barker to get it down, and Lowry skids as he kicks the ball, and it wasn't very pretty, but no. The job is done. 80-yard drive, 10 plays.
You're going to see motion, and you're going to see guards pulling, and Marcus Allen, as he's done throughout his career. Kimball Anders, 38, a good lead block. Zott, 79, an excellent block. And Marcus Allen, who told us last night, he said that, "I chose Kansas City because this offense fit my talents. I could catch the ball a lot and run the ball on the goal line." And man, has he done both.
Oh, he said, told us earlier in the year, he said, when I played with Roger Craig with the Raiders, I used to kid him, say, envied him being in that 49er offense. And so remembering that when the opportunity arose, Kansas City was the call. Only 5 others have scored more touchdowns in this league than Marcus Allen. I wonder who they are. Oh, there they are. Brown, Peyton, Rice, Riggins, Lenny Moore. Why are you marking Lenny Moore?
Because he's the guy, I think, who most resembles, good word, Dick, resembles Marcus Allen in the way they played. Excellent receiver, ran for a lot of touchdowns, very elusive, and Joe Montana knows where the soft hands and talent lie.
You know, you using those big words, and Marty likes the word unequivocally. And he uses that when he says Marcus Allen is not just the best, he is unequivocally the best player I've ever seen down on the goal line.
I'll let Marty use those big words from here on out, Dick.
But the point is that the man produces in that red zone.
Absolutely. Has throughout his career. This is not a new trait that Marcus Allen has suddenly found.
So it's 14-3. As Kansas City attempts to end the drought in Denver. And the long kick by Lowry, and Milburn will take the touchback. And that gives us a chance to remind you, as you have been throughout the course of this weekend, that New Year's Day will be a happy way to start for the football fan. A triple header you'll first see at 1 o'clock Eastern, the IBM OS2 Fiesta Bowl, Miami, Arizona, then Notre Dame, Texas A&M in the Mobile Cotton, and finally the matchup, number 1 Nebraska with a Heisman winner, Charlie Ward. Check that. Nebraska number 1 with the Butkus winner, Trev Alberts, against Florida State number 2. Yeah, that was Freudian. Number 1 Florida State, they're only favored by 17 points. Elway, good protection. And then he's hit from behind and fumbles. Neil Smith forced the fumble, and Elway is able to recover.
The bat move.
Neil Smith celebrates his sack with that little baseball swing of his.
In deference to George Brett. But there was an incident in Kansas City this week that almost upset the entire football team. That's Neil Smith around Zimmerman. Great coverage downfield. Someone stole Neil Smith's bat. Was holding it for ransom.
He's got a red. Someone sent him in the spirit of the Kansas City Red, a Kansas City baseball bat in red with his name on it. And they don't beat the clock. And there again, a delay of game. And he was trying to find out just who the culprits were. It was well orchestrated with a letter of ransom. How much money did they want for
the bet? They wanted $300. They wanted it at 50-yard line, 4 o'clock today.
It was a mystery. Was it Joe Montana? Oh, no. Or the ever-clever Marcus Allen.
He knew too much about it last night. He knew too much.
Linebackers can be evil, Derek Thomas.
No. They're good buddies. He wouldn't do it.
The latest rumor is it's a wide receiver. Elway from deep in his own end. Oh, his receiver had fallen, intercepted by Mincy, and Kansas City has it at the 30-yard line. Shannon Sharp slipped and fell, and Mincy has his fifth interception of the year. He leads Kansas City.
And Dick, again, you saw John Elway looking and looking and looking and looking. There is an awful lot of time for him to stand back there. Again, great coverage by Kansas City from behind Mincy. You can see the pressure, and Elway's trying to find anybody to throw it to. There's Sharp that falls down, slips. Of course, they play baseball on this turf now, and that's right at the end where the Colorado Rockies have their infield.
Charles Mincy, the leader in thefts for the Chiefs.
Well, you don't want to give Joe Montana
the short field.
The short field.
6:13 left in the half. 14-3 Kansas City. Todd McNair in motion. Kimball Anders gets the call. He's to the 26, a pickup of 5. Shane Drenet, the tackler.
Boy, the defense was coming all out. Blitzes everywhere. Charles Mincy, congratulations. Watch 77 coming. This is a great call. There's Dennis Smith, 49, coming. All out blitz. Watch Mecklenburg. Tackles Joe Montana, thinking he has the ball. Anders picks up, what, 4, 5, 6 yards?
5. It'll be 2nd and 5.
So far, nothing that Denver has done defensively has hurt Kansas City.
Charlie Waters, their defensive coordinator, who played against Montana. And Montana and Dwight Clark hooked up in the catch in the playoffs. Again, a full blitz, and Montana throws incomplete. Willie Davis, the closest white jersey. Tyrone Braxton on him.
Dick, the Denver Broncos are emptying their defensive bucket here. I mean, they have called anything and everything they can think of. Watch what happens here again. You got people coming from everywhere to try to disrupt Joe Montana. And he sees, hey, I don't have a receiver open, I'll throw it away. Montana has always protected himself very well in the pocket.
Marty Schottenheimer not at all pleased that something better didn't come out of that. 3rd and 5.
Blitz again.
Wide open is Jones. Fred Jones from Grambling, who has only 9 catches, and from that reaction, Joe blames himself.
Yes. You don't get him that much open, and Joe Montana doesn't miss many. But again, look at the blitz. I mean, Denver's trying anything and everything they can think of.
Oh, was Jones 10 yards in the clear.
Just overthrown. And he knows it. Ah, he's always one to put it on himself. Never blames the other guy. Just puts it on himself. They got the right play called. Joe just can't get it to the receiver.
So it's Lowry for a 44-yard field goal. It's hooking. No good. Wide left. So the Bronco fans, with little to cheer in this first half, see hope in the miss.
He hasn't missed many in his career. It's a little rough out there between the hash marks, and generally speaking, when a kicker misses it left, he's swinging his leg a little too hard. That's a hook.
So the interception by Mincy comes up empty for Kansas City. It remains 14-3.
I'm holding. Bruce missed you, man. Do you know what Bruce does in these shoes, man? Bad things, man. I mean bad things. Things that I just can't possibly talk about. You know what Bruce would do if he found me messing with this shoe, man? Bad things, man.
People around Flat Rock, Michigan feel more secure driving the Mazda 626. They make them themselves, so they put dual airbags in every one of theirs. And every one of yours, too.
It's Domino's 20.
$25 million Super Mario All-Star Instant Win Game. With every order, get a free chance to win thousands of special power set prizes. Now buy our new crunchy thin crust pizza and get free twisty bread.
Something for nothing when you call Domino's.
You build a new razor with precision heads to shave below the skin in comfort. And what do you get? Color precision groove to help the Norelco lift and cut system shave even closer. And what do you get? Build a razor that shaves closer, smoother than ever before. And what do you get? The new Norelco razors. Our closest shave ever.
In Flat Rock, Michigan, they build the Mazda 626 so that even with its V6 engine, it still costs less than a four-cylinder Camry LE. Around Flat Rock, they think that's a powerful argument for the 626. And so do we.
You don't beat Joe Montana with just one. You get the whole team around you.
As Charlie Waters down there in the middle, trying his best to design something else to stop Joe Montana. They've not put anything out there to even slow Kansas City down.
Some of the fans taking a split screen to a human level here in Denver. Bernstein on first down. Fights through one tackle at Dan Saliamoa and gets out to the 28-yard line where Joe Phillips makes the stop. And a look at the natural gas quarterback efficiency ratings featuring the top two in the AFC, Montana and Elway in this game. Boomer with a 3-0 win yesterday in the nation's capital. Neil O'Donnell, Jim Kelly, understand, came up with an injured ankle today. And Frank Reich rallied the Bills to victory at Philly. Warren Moon, come from behind win at home, number 8 in a row for the Oilers today. Kansas City, 178-70 in yards in this half. Second and 8 for Elway. For the flat. Michael Marshall. And he's right at the yardsticks. They're going to spot it shy of the 36. So it'll be not enough for the first down.
Dick, I think Denver's going to have to get used to throwing the ball out there in the flat. Kansas City's coming with a lot of 6 defensive backs. I think Wade Phillips is realizing here that when Marshall got hurt, when Russell got hurt and without Vance Johnson, what they're doing is doubling Shannon Sharp inside, and the only thing they're allowing are the little short out routes on the outside. So Denver's got to find something else to do offensively.
They're going to bring the chains all the way across to measure. And it is short by that much. Third and inches. The Denver Broncos comparing Dan Reeves' offense of a year ago with Wade Phillips. More than a touchdown a game and considerable yardage for this offense. They call the West Coast offense. Those who don't want to give San Francisco full credit.
Jim Fossil is the coordinator. Wade spends more time with the defense. There's Fossil on the sideline.
Won the quarterback at Southern Cal and Long Beach State. Played briefly 1 year in the NFL. Third and inches. And it's Delpino, the short yardage expert for Denver, who gets the first down.
I'd say with the way Denver's struggled offensively to this point in this first half, this is a key drive for him. Points of some sort across the 50-yard line, something here.
4 minutes to go in this half. 5 first downs for Denver, all rushing in this half.
They're taking away his underneath receivers. Double covering them all over the place.
Elway on a roll this time. Almost intercepted by Tracy Simeon, who cut in front of Cedric Tillman.
Dick, it looked to me like the primary receiver was Shannon Sharp.
And he was open.
Yeah, he blocked momentarily as he rolls. You'll see Shannon Sharp there. Right there. He's open, but John chooses to go downfield trying to get it to Tillman, and Tracy Simeon almost comes up with the next pick. And now look at the situation that the Kansas City has Denver in. Third and long, and Kansas City comes in with, I count, 7 defensive backs. Look at him. This is what he faces now.
Out of the shotgun, 2nd and 10. Over the middle, complete to Marshall, and he has a first down at the 48, maybe the 49. Jay Taylor, one of those extra defensive backs, made the tackle at the 49.
Now there's single coverage here. Taylor 27 on Marshall, and Marshall wins the battle. Good job of separating himself from the coverage, and Elway puts it right on the money.
Arthur Marshall knows all about covering the 100 yards here as a real estate major at the University of Georgia.
Elway working without the experienced receivers now, with Russell and Marshall. Russell hurt, Vance Johnson hurt, flag down.
Yeah, I think Kansas City got a timeout. They had too many men on the field, and let's see what happened. Yeah, 77 was
Cullen McDaniels
was on the field. Let's see if they
can. Timeout, Denver.
No.
First charge team timeout.
It's Kansas City.
That'll be corrected.
Kansas City.
Wade says, I'll take it if you want.
Here's 77, and Dale Carter motions to the official right here and gets the timeout.
So the Chiefs have used all their timeouts. 3:04 to go. And the Denver Broncos with a first down at midfield.
There's the offensive brain trust there. Sean Moore, Tommy Maddox, the two backup quarterbacks. Jim Fossil on the left with the headset.
Gives us a chance, as these Sterling fans would suggest, to think about next week, next Sunday. What do we have? NFL Live at 12:30. Buffalo at Miami. We'll be down at Joe Robbie for a game that could well decide who gets home field playoffs ahead. Houston travels to Pittsburgh in another outstanding clash. New England and Cleveland. The late game San Diego will be at Arrowhead. Four to go before the intermission. Delfino Andrews in the backfield this time, and Elway shoots to the tight end. Reggie Johnson has been out for a couple of games with a hamstring. That's his 16th catch of the year for 16 yards.
Dick, Kansas City missed the coverage there. They had Kevin Ross moved over there late. He's the free safety. Martin Bayless was totally out of position.
From the 35, Elway sends Marshall to the right. Goes with the two tight ends. And Bernstein flares to the left. Underneath to Sharp. And Shannon Sharp, 10 more to the 25. Martin Bayless the tackler. Shannon says, come on, let's get going here. Mile high.
Actually, he should be doing that to John Elway. He's been open a couple of times. John has not thrown it to him.
It is a first down as seconds tick down to the two-minute timeout. Kansas City hasn't won here in 10 years, leading 14-3.
Turn it up.
Portable stereos devour power. But the music goes on and on with Rayovac Renewal. A new kind of alkaline battery created to be reusable. They outlive those bunny batteries because they're reusable 25 times or more. They outperform old-fashioned rechargeables because you get alkaline power in every charge. More power, more music. That's the power of renewal from Rayovac.
And now for some thin, different.
New Domino's Thin Crust Pizza. A crispy, crunchy crust pizza. Now, buy any thin crust pizza and get an order of Domino's Twisty Bread free.
Something for nothing when you call Domino's.
Geronimo thunders across the big screen like a herd of wild horses. Jason Patrick, Robert Duvall, Gene Hackman, and Wes Studi as Geronimo. Rated PG-13. At theaters now.
AT&T has prepared a statement we would now like to present. Introducing AT&T Maximum Advantage. AT&T guarantees in writing that your business will get our lowest price, or we'll automatically credit you the difference. We'll make recommendations quarterly to help you do business in more efficient ways, even internationally. And as we introduce new technology and services to help your business grow, you will learn about them here. Look in the mail for this valuable statement from AT&T. Thank you. End of statement.
Dave Adolph and Marty Schottenheimer discussing the defense as John Elway drives his team to the 25. A first down with 2 minutes to go, trailing 14-3. Kansas City scoring on a Montana pass to Hayes and an Allen run. And Domino's Pizza halftime report coming up with Jim Lampley. Joe Gibbs joins Mike Ditka. How about those ties? Oh, I thought Joe Gibbs and I were going for the all-vanilla award, but not with that tie he's wearing today.
I think they walked from the hotel to the studio and hit one of those carts on the side of 49th Street.
Might have gotten a watch thrown in. Elway, the tie. Hits his tight end again, and Johnson has it. First and goal at the 7. Showing up big chunks. That's 13 more.
Well, this one should come right at you. Here's the receiver right over here. It's linebacker coverage, Tracy Simeon. Simeon never looks back. Boy, that is an accurate throw by John Elway.
Clock running, 1:34. Broncos have all their timeouts left. They don't want to score too soon here, so they're not going to use one at this point. 4 shots from the 7 to make this one tight at halftime. And out of bounds at the 6-yard line. Neil Smith made sure he didn't go upfield.
Excellent coverage by Kansas City, and Robert Delpino was out in front of John Elway. And if you're kind of in a can't win situation, if you're the running back, you make yourself a receiver, you block for the quarterback. As it was, he picked up very little yardage.
10th play of this drive, 1:16 left in the half. Elway gaining 1 yard on the scramble. Bobby Brown to Bernstein, and he's toppled at the 4. Did not fool the Chiefs. Lonnie Martz, 51, submarining to make the stop.
This is an aggressive front 7 for Kansas City. They try their darndest to, Sally Amua goes up. He looks hurt.
Big guy from Arizona State. Clock still running, 47-46. Elway watching the clock and apparently is going to call time after he uses almost the full complement. It's down to 4 on the play clock, 2, and spends his time out with 1 second. So that's exactly right. Elway wants to score, leave Kansas City with no time to counter.
Today, 19,000 people will start their day at sunrise. Thousands of fathers will hold their child for the first time. And millions of people will keep track of their time with a Citizen Watch in Paris. It's a Citizen Elegance. In the South Pacific, a Citizen ProMaster. But from Nepal to New York, more people depend on a watch made by Citizen than any other timepiece. Citizen Watches, how the world tells time.
Watch what happens to Sally Amua and the knee of Rod Bernstein. You wonder why Dan went to the sideline. 97. That's a stinger. Give you a headache. Also make your neck burn a little bit.
Sally Amua, a concrete man. He says he still goes down to Phoenix and admires the building where he poured concrete when the days weren't so bright for him. And he was unknown with the Lions. 3rd and goal. 2-minute motion. That'll be a flag on that. Elway throws. Complete at the 1-yard line to Shannon Sharp. You can't have 2 guys running unless you're playing north of the border.
You're right. It's allowed in Canada. John didn't even see the other guy in motion.
Damon Allen up there in Eskimos country. Edmonton get away with that. Marcus Allen's brother, who won the Grey Cup and was the MVP, as you heard on the pre-game chat with OJ. Marcus wants to say, hey, he's got 2 MVPs in Canada to win the championship. I need another to match my kid brother, the quarterback for Edmonton. What a family, huh?
Illegal motion on the offense. 2 men moving at the same time. 5-yard penalty. Repeat 3rd down.
Dick, you call that perfectly. And yeah, you know, you talk about the Edmonton Eskimos and Damon Allen. That was the spot first made famous by one Warren Moon up there in Edmonton, you know?
Mm-hmm,
so yes. Damon Allen following in the footsteps of a very big star.
To the 5-yard penalty, back to the 9, 28 seconds left in the half. six Denver penalties here in this first half. Sharp family is incredible. Leading receiver for the Broncos this year. He's got 60 on the season, and that's his fifth touchdown. Elam's try for point. And the Denver Broncos on a typical Elway, final 2 minutes of a half, drive pulled within 14-10.
Dick Sharp runs a very smart pattern here. He's lined up here, and when he gets to them here, he kind of hesitates for a minute, and then there. And Elway is waiting for him all the way. Watch the little hesitation here, you see? And then he moves. And Elway with that arm of his, easy pickings. And the Hulk. You can see Elway's looking for Sharp all the way. And when the defense drops him, yes, sir.
There's the move. Look at the muscle. He happened to walk by us with just his skivvies on the other day. This guy has, he must have body fat about 2%.
2%, yes, you're right.
Elway, 74-yard drive and 11 plays. And the Bronco fans quite well accustomed to that kind of work by their outstanding quarterback.
And is that so important for Denver? Get the fans back here in Mile High Stadium into the game, help a lot.
Well, just to believe the way Montana was controlling the action in Kansas City, it looked a bit as gray as the weather is becoming, and this is about the time the snow was supposed to arrive, and the clouds are much heavier overhead.
Dick, that drive by Denver there may have been as important as a fourth quarter drive they may need later. That gets psychology back on the side of the Denver Broncos, players and fans.
Elam might have been ordered just to skid this one down, as Kansas City has no timeouts. You don't want a long return. Harvey Williams is the deep man. No? And he kicks the high short one to Williams at the 10. And Williams hit at the 24-yard line. Darryl Hall and Anthony Lynn make the tackle. So Montana has 18 seconds.
You know, I think if I'm Marty Schottenheimer with my 0-10 here, I think I just kneel down, take the 14 points I got, go in halftime. You don't want anything stupid here that can add fuel to this Denver fire here now that they've got a little bit.
That's what's going to happen. This will just be the kneel down as the wings pick up. And Marty Schottenheimer personally is 0-7 here in Denver, counting his losses as the Cleveland coach. So Montana and Elway, the battle of two of the top NFL quarterbacks. And at the intermission, the Chiefs 14, the Broncos 10. We'll be right back after these messages from your local station.
Tuesday on an all-new Larriquette. John's nephew's in town.
We're the original Beavis and Butthead.
But he's got a problem, and only John can save him on a special holiday Larriquette. Then, on an all-new second half, it's the latest cure for baldness.
Didn't try that spray paint stuff, did you?
Why do you ask?
No reason.
All-new NBC Tuesday.
Tragedy's waiting to happen. A Dateline investigation pinpoints America's most dangerous bridges. Will you be driving over one? Don't miss Dateline NBC Tuesday.
If you want, need, or just gotta have a full-size pickup, your Ford dealer's making it easy with the lowest lease rate ever on Ford F-150. $209 a month for 24 months. And hey, this isn't one of those long-term stripped-down deals either. For $209 a month, you're getting a truck that's fully loaded. Plus, after 24 months, you can get a new truck. Buy the one you got or just walk from the whole deal. No ball and chain here. So if you want, need, or just gotta have a pickup, check out the lowest lease ever on the Ford F-150. Only at your Ford dealer, the Truck Authority.
Join Total and News Channel 4 for Family Fun Night with the Blades on December 18th. Four great seats, four hot dogs, four Cokes, and $5 in total gasoline for just $30. For tickets for Family Fun Night, 816-842-1063.
When a mother goes to prison, who's really being punished? Find out Monday in a Focus 4 report on News Channel 4 at 10.
This Oldsmobile Cutlass Supreme Special Edition costs $6,500 less than a Nissan Maxima GXE. So when Nissan says it's time to expect more from a car, they must be talking price. And the same Cutlass Supreme costs $6,300 less than a Toyota Camry LE. Yeah, Toyota wants you to pay over $6,000 more and say, I love what you do for me. Hey, it's your money.
Is News Channel 4, Kansas City's 24-hour news channel.
A shooting at a Westport bar puts a man in the hospital. Welcome to News Channel 4's halftime report. I'm Dave Helen. Topping our news at this hour, violence at a popular night spot leaves one man in serious condition. The shooting happened outside the Harris House early this morning. Police say the victim was shot in the head. Witnesses say the fight may have been over a woman. Streets are in an area were blocked off for a time, but no one has been arrested. We're told there's a metal detector at Harris House, but some people at the bar this morning say not everyone was required to walk through it. A man walking to his front door last night was shot several times. Police in Kansas City, Kansas have no suspects. The victim's mother was reportedly in her bedroom when she heard the shots. She ran out to find her son lying in the doorway. Police have not released the victim's name, but say he is a black male, possibly in his late 20s. The man's injuries are not reported to be life-threatening. Well, the Chiefs today are helping protect children from sexual abuse. Fireworks, a local company that specializes in fire and water restoration, is sponsoring a game-watching party. All proceeds from the event will go to Project Aware. It's an educational program for elementary school kids made available through MOXA, the Metropolitan Organization to Counter Sexual Assault. Project Aware shows kids what to do to protect themselves from sexual abuse. Well, if you're out looking for the sun, don't be surprised if you can't find it for a few days. Your forecast is next.
How do you satisfy an appetite as big as Arrowhead Stadium? First, you get a little charcoal. Then you light it and get your grill good and hot. Finally, you get a big, juicy Price Chopper steak. Price Chopper meats are always 1/8-inch trim. No extra fat. Just lean, healthy meat that'll satisfy even the biggest appetite.
Fat is the enemy of speed.
Price Chopper's 1/8-inch trimmed meat makes a lot of sense.
Most car owners praise the quality of their purchases. But only one car line has been ranked best overall in initial quality by J.D. Power and Associates. Lexus. So the question isn't whether you put your car on a pedestal, but how often. And the Lexus LS is thousands less than the leading European competition.
At Superior Lexus.
Well, it's been overcast and windy today, as you may know, but this is the best weather we're going to see for a while. Let's take a look at your forecast. Tonight, rain developing is the prediction with a low of 44 degrees. Then tomorrow, rain likely changing perhaps to snow by the evening with a high of 45 degrees, but the temperature will drop throughout the day. Then on Tuesday, a high just above freezing, 34 degrees with a possibility of snow flurries. On Wednesday, cloudy skies and 38. Then temperatures again falling through the day on Thursday and Friday with a low around freezing and again a chance of precipitation. In Denver, the Chiefs could be seeing some more of that snow before we do. The forecast there is calling for snow by the fourth quarter. Well, enjoy the rest of this real good game. We'll see you back here after the Chiefs game for a post-game special report on News Channel 4.
The anticipated games in the league this year, Montana versus Elway. Kansas City leads Denver 14-10 at halftime. Mike, both quarterbacks had their moments in the first half.
Well, Montana looked unbelievable in the first couple drives, but then, you know, you can never count Denver out. Elway is such a good football player, and he's a guy that probably won more games coming back than anybody I know except Roger Staubach. So this guy put him back, got a big touchdown at the end of the first half. So they're right back in the game. It can go either way.
As usual, much on Elway's shoulders, Joe. They lose another receiver to injury. Not much of a running game, but he's got him in there.
Yeah, that was a classic drive right before half. Sometimes I wonder, you know, why they don't
I put the guy, I think, in a no-huddle all the time, just let him call it and go. I mean, the guy's so good at that. And I've seen him do that earlier in the year. I'm not so sure that's the way to operate with Elway. Just let him go from the first second on.
Quick note to Wade Phillips. Joe Gibbs says try the no-huddle all the time. Meanwhile, down in the Los Angeles Coliseum, the Raiders have just gotten a Jeff Hostetler touchdown run. In the seconds before halftime, they lead the Seahawks 10-9 at intermission. Dallas Cowboys are getting big first halves from both Emmitt Smith and Michael Irvin. Irvin with his fifth 100-yard receiving game of the year. They lead 17-6 over Minnesota. Detroit Lions have their first touchdown since Barry Sanders went out on Thanksgiving Day. It was a Kramer to Moore touchdown pass that tied Phoenix 7-7 at halftime. Earlier today, in the Meadowlands and Giants Stadium, the New York Giants became the first team in the league to win 10 games this year. First to clinch a playoff berth. They did it on the strength of Rodney Hampton's running. 16 yards down to the Indy 1 in the first quarter here. He scored on the next play to make it 7-0. Hampton finished career-high 173 yards on 33 carries. Second quarter, still 7-0 Giants. Bill Sims mixes it up with this perfect shot to Chris Callaway, 17 yards over good coverage. The point after touchdown was botched, and that made it 13-0 Giants. Giants reestablishing the tradition of dousing a winning coach with Gatorade as Dan Reeves' team clinches a playoff berth 20-6, and the Giants don't have a lot of variety, Joe, but what they do so well.
They do extremely well. Dan's getting pretty good. Notice a little sidestep there to miss. That's not bad. I tell you, they look like the Giants of old to me. Run the football, precise passing by Sims. Nothing's changed about this place. Last night, Pat and I got trapped down the street, and it's still freezing cold up there. It's a tough place to play, particularly if the Giants playing the way they are.
That
right
would
now.
Be Pat Gibbs, the missus,
Pat Gibbs.
Right?
Yeah.
There have been so many others. Meanwhile, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers halt the Chicago Bear winning streak. 13-10 is the final there. Only one Buccaneer turnover in the game, and the Bears, as usual, couldn't muster much on offense. They live and die with that defense, Mike.
Well, Jim Harbaugh got hurt right before the end of the first half, and they brought in P.Q. Willis, and he did a good job. They generated a touchdown with him in there and a field goal. But I think right now the Bears are living on one dimension. You know, they need a two-edged sword. You got to have offense, defense. They play pretty good special teams. They play great defense. Right now they haven't been able to generate anything on offense. You hold a team to 13 points in the National Football League, you should win most of those games. The Bears have given up, I think, the second least number of points in the league, and they got a winning record, but they'll never be a great team until they get the offense on track.
Bears dropped to 7-6. Now must hope that Detroit will lose and also Minnesota. Cleveland Browns put up a good fight, but lose to the Houston Oilers 19-17. The fourth Del Greco field goal decides it. It was Warren Moon with the play-action fake in the first half as Cleveland led 10-6. Moon, after a slow start, hit Spencer Tillman for that four-yard touchdown that puts Houston ahead for the first time 13-10. 16-10, favor Houston in the third. Vinny Testaverde finds Mark Carrier between two Oilers, and that 28-yard TD puts the Browns back on top 17-16. But a critical play, Testaverde looks for Carrier again, is picked off by Chris Dishman of the Oilers. This leads to Al Del Greco's fourth field goal, and the Oilers, with the big play defense, win for the eighth consecutive time, 19-17. Rams upset the Saints behind 212 rushing yards from Jerome Bettis. 23-20 the final there. The Rams get their fourth win of the year. Cincinnati falls to New England in the battle in Foxborough as the Patriots get their second victory. Drew Bledsoe with a conservative game. One touchdown pass to Ben Coates. 7-2. New England over Cincy. We'll send it back to Dick Enberg and Bob Trumpy for the second half of the Chiefs and the Broncos right after these messages from your local station.
If you want, need, or just gotta have a full-size pickup, your Ford dealer's making it easy with the lowest lease rate ever on Ford F-150. $209 a month for 24 months. And hey, this isn't one of those long-term stripped-down deals either. For $209 a month, you're getting a truck that's fully loaded. Plus, after 24 months, you can get a new truck. Buy the one you got or just walk from the whole deal. No ball and chain here. So if you want, need, or just gotta have a pickup, check out the lowest lease ever on the Ford F-150. Only at your Ford dealer, the Truck Authority.
Not every emergency at St. Joseph Health Center utilizes our trauma center capability. Sometimes you just need a little help in a hurry. So right next to our regular emergency department is Emergency Quick Care. In about half the time, for about half the cost of regular emergency treatment, a physician like Dr. Mark Holcomb will treat that painful earache, awful flu, nasty cough, big bad cold, or little owie. Emergency Quick Care. Open evenings and weekends at St. Joseph Health Center.
Support the Children of the Love Fund. Pick up a celebrity cookbook for friends and family.
20 years ago, my teammates with the Kansas City Chiefs started to bring you the United Way stories of volunteers helping people in need, especially children. When I joined the team, I had a goal, to someday volunteer to join that group of players and be part of the United Way Great Moments series.
I'm Nick Lowry of the Kansas City Chiefs.
Well, I did make that United Way spot back in 1983. I met a boy named William who received support from your United Way contributions. The boy that appeared in that spot with me is with me today. He's a winner, and so are all of you who give to our United Way here in Kansas City, because United Way in Kansas City is still ensuring that your contribution is spent wisely. I hope you'll never give up on helping children, and I know they'll never give up trying. Your support gives them that special courage to make it. Now more than ever, the United Way, helping where help is needed most.
This message furnished by the National Football League.
And we welcome you back to Mile High Stadium. Second half about to start. Kansas City leading 14-10. And on Elway with one of his masterful drives to get the Broncos right back in it at the half.
Yeah, you can't talk about Joe Montana and John Elway without just marveling at their ability to just grasp when it gets important and know when they've got to come up with the big plays. And here is the touchdown that was thrown to Shannon Sharp. What's happening here is you've got double coverage out here by Kansas City. You got a man watching the running back here. You got him here. These two guys bite. Sharp makes the adjustment to come right open in the end zone, and John Elway with that strong arm is able to find him. Now that's good coverage by Kansas City, but the defensive backs broke the cardinal sin whenever you play Denver. You can never drop coverage on any receiver when you play John Elway. You cover that guy until the whistle blows. And the zone defense of Kansas City just got had by John Elway on that one, Dick.
Well, the Coors Light halftime statistics bear out how even the half was.
Even, fairly even, almost even. Yeah, well played.
And Denver will get the ball first. Severe sprain of the ankle, the report on Derrick Russell, the starting wide receiver for John Elway, and will not return. The good news on the weather is the snowstorm has stalled apparently over the mountains and is not expected here till 7 o'clock local time, so should not impact the game, although the northern winds have picked up. It's much colder, and kickers going right to left are going to have some problems in the second half. Lowry kicking with the wind at his back, and he drives it into the end zone where Delpino will take the kneel down. John Elway comes on. Dan Saliamua is one that he may not see in the defense of Kansas City. Report on Saliamua, who is injured, appeared to be a neck injury, is that he may not return and has been replaced by Nate Newton's brother, Tim Newton, number 96. So it'll be Joe Phillips and Tim Newton, the big tackles inside for KC. Trying to continue the magic that he had floating around this field at the end of the half. Oh my, Bernstein runs into a wall of white and a gain of just a couple. And Newton was one of them. Played his football at Florida, was drafted by Minnesota in 85.
You know, it's surprising that Newton is that big. You'd figure his big brother Nate got all the food, but Tim seems to have walked up to the dinner table there a few times too.
He's 6 feet tall, 269.
He's at least 269.
I wonder if he likes french fries as much as his brother.
Nobody likes french fries as much as Nate.
He's looking for an all right, a commercial. Again, into the center of the line for short yardage. Two, maybe three, goes Milburn, his first carry of the game.
Dick, you can see Denver here trying to at least threaten Kansas City with the run to give John Elway some room to throw.
I suppose Elway looked at the new face there, Newton, and said, well, let's test him out. Newton makes the tackles.
These numbers aren't good enough. Those numbers certainly weren't good enough. But again, now it's third and medium yardage for Elway to convert here.
So he goes shotgun. This is where he's dangerous on the run. He's throwing for Bernstein. All the way to the 35 of Kansas City. Longest longest play of the game, 41 yards.
Kansas City threatens blitz to keep running backs in, and Doug Terry drops coverage on the running back. Another break of that cardinal rule against John Elway. You're gonna see him come out here and up the field, and Doug Terry just never really gets the coverage on him. Bumps him there, and it kind of lets him go. And Elway, what a beautiful touch on that pass.
On first down, Bernstein to the 31-yard line. Tracy Simeon completes the work started by Derek Thomas. So the first completion to a running back is a big one. 41 yards, and Elway, what a master. How many can throw that accurately running against his body? And Joe Phillips is the injured Kansas City Chief. Already losing Saliamua in the middle, the veteran Phillips down. Timeout, 12:38 left in the third.
So you think driving an Oldsmobile 88 is like sitting in your living room? You got a photo of your living room here. Love the couch. Now take a look at the 88 LSS. Cooler seats, much better sound system. Plus, it handles better than your living room. Not to mention many cars. So if you're gonna sit down, at least do it someplace good. It's your money.
Hi, everybody.
Dave, we're all worried.
About what?
You haven't ordered your holiday ham from my store.
Or the cookies I made for you.
Or your turkey.
Or your egg bar.
Or your fruitcake.
Yeah, what gives?
Nothing. Wendy's is making a new Big Bacon Classic Combo.
Oh. It's a quarter pound of fresh beef, three strips of bacon, and the works with Biggie fries and a cold drink. So this holiday, save your appetite.
And I thought you forgot my prune tart.
Who could forget that?
Try Wendy's Big Bacon Classic Combo today.
After all these years, Watson, the trail is decidedly cold.
But Holmes, it's quite warm in here.
All these years.
Curiously cozy.
No. Fiendishly clever. Observe, Watson. Warm house, many years. It must be...
Lennox.
Elementary, my dear Watson.
For home heating, for cooking, for hot water, use clean natural gas. America's best energy value.
The NFL on NBC is brought to you by Oldsmobile. By Dr. Pepper and your local Dr. Pepper bottler. Dr. Pepper is just what the doctor ordered. By Lennox. When quality gas heating is a must be a Lennox. And by Magnavox. The ingenious products from Magnavox. They're smart, very smart.
Phillips left under his own power. Darren Nickel, 92, replaces him. Second and seven for Elway. Trailing 14-10, early third quarter. Glenn Milburn trying to get the little guy outside. And makes a good move. Makes something out of nothing with a 25, just shy of the first down. Well, what was it that Ditka said yesterday on the pregame show? Something about too many lawyers in the game. Well, Joe Phillips is a lawyer. And this is what happened to him on the last play.
Former teammates, here's Rod Bernstein to watch Phillips. Watch what happens. Bernstein puts his head right into him, and then Phillips trips over carts. Lands right on his back.
Pretty good block by Burns.
Yeah, Ditka must really hate Joe Phillips. He's married to a lawyer, too.
Third down and one. Burns hit, but drives forward, appears to have the first down. Tim Newton made the tackle. So with two fresh men inside, Newton and Nickel, not starters, Wade Phillips goes right at him, and a first down at the 23.
And hey, Rod Bernstein's come out here with a fire. I mean, that long reception down the sideline, the first catch by a running back today, and those rushing yards, I mean, all they have to do is just threaten this defense, and then you hope Rod Bernstein will break one for pretty good distance.
On first down, they take out the tight end, so three wide receivers for Elway. Incomplete. Intended for Tony Kimbrough, who's caught only one pass all year, and the veteran Albert Lewis there to break it up.
Derek Thomas, for the first time today, got pressure on John Elway. Tries to jump inside Freeman, then as he rolls, Elway rolls, Thomas is there. I don't think there's ever been a quarterback in the game better at that than John Elway. Rolling, setting, throwing, and throwing with steam for the shooter. Close call. Both were looking at the ball. Incidental contact.
second and 10. Delay to Melbourne. Well done by the defense of the Chiefs and Darren Nichol. Another Florida Gator there to make the stop along with Doug Terry.
Yeah, Dick, Kansas City is going with the 7 defensive backs, just 4 guys up front. So Denver's countering with the draw, which is a good idea, but you're right. The defense of Kansas City is mobile enough that they're not allowing Milburn to get any head of steam.
45-year-old Wade Fox. Montana Elway, 2 yards separate from each with a touchdown pass, each has been pick ones. Kansas City, Elway with a free play, and he hits his man. How many times have we seen that? Arthur Marshall, first and goal, Elway sees the flags, knows he's got a free one, boom, 17 yards.
Darren Nichol, I believe, is the guy who was offside, the defensive tackle. We've seen that, too, that hard count. You see Nichol come across through the neutral zone, and Elway knows, aha, this is the Elway zone. Watch this throw. Boy, is that baby spinning? Woo! That's RPMs, man.
Either you catch that one or it burrows a hole in your chest.
Tattoos. Nice pattern run, Kevin Ross in coverage. But, I mean, you need to be right on the receiver to stop a bullet like that.
Quite a drive to open this second half. It's the 10th play, first and goal, as the Broncos threaten to take the lead. Nothing there. Thought he might be able to get outside, but Martin Bayless came up to close that off.
Dick, when he bounced outside, the play was over. When you've got lead blockers up in front of you and it's inside the 10-yard line, you want to get what you can and forget about being fancy.
Bernstein leads the Broncos with 613 yards. That's 13th in the NFL, but averaging only 3.4 a carry and 3.0 today. 36 yards, 13. Actually, less than that, less than 3. Elway on second and goal. Knocked down and almost intercepted by Lonnie Marks.
Intended for Shannon Sharp. Denver was running the pick. They brought Shannon Sharp in motion. You're going to see these guys go up here and try to pick off the defensive backs and watch Marks.
Whoa. Quick reactions.
Yeah. That almost stuck in his face mask.
And he's had a good year, Marks. He has an interception. He's forced 4 fumbles. So third and goal from the 4. It was.
Well, good Kansas City taking a chance here with all those defensive backs in there. There's 7 of them.
Oops, offside is Sharp. Didn't hear the count.
Well, false start, number 84 on the offense prior to the snap, 5-yard penalty, still third down.
That happened Elway at the end of the half. The penalty took it back to the 9, and he hit Sharp for the touchdown.
I don't know why Shannon would do that. He's looking in at the football, and you're supposed to go on movement, not on sound.
50 yards against Denver, a negative again as it was in their first game.
Dick, again, now Kansas City with 7 defensive backs. Bernstein is there. A trap might work. A quarterback draw might work.
From the 9-yard line. Well, there's going to be another 5 on a false start. Russell Freeman.
Or was that too much time?
Start on the offense, number 79, prior to the snap, 5-yard penalty, still third down.
Dave Wydell, 79, looked like Freeman might have been pulling back with him.
Yeah, you're right. It was more than one. Denver is going backwards here.
Now to the 14-yard line, third and goal.
The play still works, though. A draw up the middle by the quarterback.
Yeah, but 14's a lot to make from this guy.
Blitz.
Far end zone shot. Touchdown. Oh, my. What a throw. Wow. Phillips has been in football all of his life as a son of a great coach, Bum Phillips. He too punctuates with wow. Denver leads for the first time. Elam's try for point.
Dick, he's done it his entire career, John Elway. Sharp is the man in the slot. Kansas City comes with a blitz. Sharp does the smart thing. He gets right up to Mincy and then makes the move, and Elway puts it in a perfect spot for the reception and the TD.
Well, you have to know it's the 100 and, in this case, 20 yards of field and 53 and a third yards width. Does he measure that one like a surveyor and hit it right in the far corner? Wade Phillips loves the lead by three.
We're a part of the future. We're the heart and the soul. We're the voice of tomorrow, singing out the whole.
Buying a new car. Well, before you spend all that money, why not make a free call? 1-800-LSS-WINS. When you do, we'll send you a free video showing how well the Oldsmobile 88 LSS luxury sedan stacks up against cars costing thousands more. It's your money, but fortunately, it's also a free call.
Touchdown catches, one at the end of the first half, one to open the second half. Meanwhile, Montana hadn't played for over 30 minutes. Elam's kick to Harvey Williams at the goal line. And Williams skipping out to the 26, 27-yard line. 80-yard drive engineered by John Elway. It took him a dozen plays, and he was sharp to hit Shanahan.
Oh, was he ever. But here's the chance that Kansas City is taking. You've got blitzes, so you've got man coverage here, here, and here, and here. And John Elway takes absolute aim for that spot right there, the bottom of the cone, and puts it there beautifully. 6 points.
Hey, that's the telestrator of the year right there. Now the Bronco fans go to work with the lead against Montana. He knows how to quiet him. First down, comes out. Mr. Cool, 12 yards, right on the money to Willie Davis.
John Ault is down and hurt.
Left tackle John Ault having another Pro Bowl year. Montana has been sacked only once in 10-plus quarters, and that's when he tripped over Marcus Allen.
Yes, and the offensive lineman turned around and said, "What happened, Joe? What happened on the sack?" And he sheepishly thought, "I tripped over Marcus."
Take a timeout.
When they told him he didn't have the size to play, he reached inside and found the power.
Starter.
He was from a small school in a small town. But he had the heart to make it big.
Starter.
Each had a dream. And when you start with a dream, where you end up is up to you.
Starter.
Recently, Oldsmobile pitted its 88 LSS against Acura Legend L and Lexus ES300. Well, actually, no. In fact, if you call this toll-free number, 1-800-LSS-TEST, we'll send you a free video showing how well the LSS stacks up against cars costing thousands more. You'll probably be grateful. After all, it's your money.
What's in the bag? Lunch. Quarter pound of cheese, fries.
Kick you for it.
First one that misses.
I know. Watches the winner eat.
Barefoot, helmet on backwards, split the uprights. Through the tunnel, hook it, off the stone guy, split the uprights.
These guys are good.
Off the freeway, through the tunnel, off the scoreboard, split the uprights.
John Alden's on the sideline being attended to by the trainer. You see an awful lot of injuries like this. Watch Dan Williams, number 90, roll right on the ankle of John Alt. That's how the receiver from Denver got hurt earlier, Derek Russell.
But he, Alt did leave with weight on both feet. All part of that protection scheme for Montana, who has a first down on his first pitch of this second half. Well, contact before the ball was snapped. Marcus Allen is drilled. I don't see a flag. There was definitely an offside. Dave Wyman made the tackle.
Yeah, there's movement, but Dronette apparently was not in the neutral zone. Kansas City's got to recapture some control of this football game now, because
look at the comparison. Yeah. Both 12 for 18. Elway, two touchdowns to one pick. Allen again. Tripped up in the backfield for a loss. Dennis Smith, the oldest defensive back in the NFL. Teammate of Marcus Allen at USC, roommate.
And a matter of fact, there are people who say that if Denver had won their three Super Bowls, they talk about Dennis Smith the way everyone talks about Ronnie Lott. And Ronnie Lott, in that roommate situation of USC, was the cook for Marcus Allen, Dennis Smith, and Ronnie Lott.
Third and 11. Williams can't get Montana. He throws it away. How did he get out of that? But the crowd nevertheless pleased as Kansas City has stopped. Marty thought that Montana might have been hit late. Let's see.
Good coverage downfield by Denver. Again, faking the pitch. Looked like six is coming, but only four. Dan Williams chases him. Grunhard, 61, makes the block. Dronette is pretty late there, but Bernie Kukar, the referee, right on it.
Brian Barker to punt. Lynn Milburn at the 15. Wobbly spiral. Helped by the wind to the 16. Milburn takes a chance. He can get outside, but was shut off and tackled at the 22, a 47-yard punt, six on the return. A look ahead, NBC tonight, and it's a great family night here on the Peacock. Rather, the youngsters around for the Jetsons at 7 o'clock as they blast into the future with George and family, and then NBC presents the classic E.T., the most beloved movie of all time, it says here, from Steven Spielberg.
Go home. E.T., go home. Bone home.
Well, you were close.
It's not my favorite movie. I'm sorry, Dick.
Rod Bernstein to the 20. You were thinking of T.E., your favorite movie. Jim Lampley has this update.
Well, Dick, as you know, it was Tim Brown who propelled the Raiders to the victory in Buffalo last weekend. And today it's Tim Brown who takes this third quarter punt from Seattle's Rick Tootin and goes 74 yards to stretch the Raider lead to 17-9. Meanwhile, you're outdoors on grass with one of the best games of the year, and we're enjoying every minute, Dick and Bob.
Okay, Lamps, second down and 12. Tillman in motion. Elway with a short hit to Shannon Sharp. Sharp with his fourth catch gets it to the 26-yard line. Make that the lead. Short-changing Shannon. He's now up to six on the game and 63 for the year. Far below his brother, who's likely to lead the NFL again. Shannon from Savannah State. He said his worst sport in high school was football.
Yeah. He was a track athlete, a basketball athlete.
He is an athlete. Third and a long four. Elway, chased by Derek Thomas, makes the throw, complete to Kimbrough. Tony Kimbrough's second catch of the year, first down. Elway's magic still alive.
Dickey has taken over the game. John Elway has taken over the game. This is not what John Elway has done earlier this season. He stood in there and thrown the ball away. But now he's running like the John Elway of old. He's taking over the game. Kansas City runs a stunt.
Derek Thomas, 58 that. After him. And now Elway goes deep. Incomplete. Intended for Melvin Bonner.